アッシリア・アンティオケ、その国の王アンタイオカスには美しい娘がいました。あまりの美しさに思う恋をしてしまいました。そうとは知らず多くの王貴族がやってきますが、アンタイオカスは娘を我が物にと望み、恐ろしい掟を定めます。娘が欲しければ謎を解け、解けなければ命はないと。しかしこれまで誰も謎を解けず、多くの者が命を落としていったのです。But now a ship comes sailing on the tide, a
The fatal end with death. and cover cheeks. Advise you to desist.
Tell us. I thank you. I have put the fire of love to you. Thus ready for the way of life or death. I with the sharpest blow, Antiochus.
Calling advice, hear the conclusion then, which hard one not expounded. This decree has been for you. You yourself shall die.
Of all who have tried, may you prove prosperous. Of all who have tried, I wish you happiness.
Like a bold champion, I accept that challenge. No ask advice of any other thought, but faithfulness and courage.
I am no serpent, yet I feed on mother's flesh which did me breed. I sought a husband, in which labor I found the kindness in the father. He is father, son, and husband mild. I, mother, wife, and yet his child. How they may be one, and yet in two. As you will live, resolve issue.
If this be true, it makes me pale to see it. Fair glass of light, I loved you, but now I care not for you.
Well, Pericles! Your time is expired. Either expound now or detain your sentence.
Great king, if touch yourself too near for me to tell it, it is enough. You know.
He found meaning, but a deception. Young Prince of Tyre, 40 days longer we do offer you. If by which time our secrets be undone, we'll show you our masters, making you our son. Meaning for which you need to have his help. He must not live to trumpet forth my infamy. And therefore, instantly, this prince must die! Hail Athenas, sir!
Did your highness call?
Dario, behold, here's poison. And here's gold. We hate the prince of Tyre, and you must kill him. It fits you not to ask the reason why. Because we bid it. Say, is it done?
My lord, it is done.
Now. My lord, Prince Pericles is dead. Tyrion, fly up down like an arrow shot. Never return unless you say, Prince Pericles is dead. Then my heart can bend no stagger through my head.
Thank you.
Medicaid, attend me. I went to Antioch, where, as you know, I saw the marriage there, a glorious beauty. Her face was to mine beyond all wonder. The left, hark in your ear, as black as incest. And now to keep his bed of blackness hidden deep, Antiochus will fill this land with hostile arms.
Alexa!
I love to all, which yourself, Urban, draw sweep out of my eyes, blood from my cheeks, how I might stop this tempest ere it comes.
Well, Pyrrhus, you fear Antiochus, who now by war will take away your life. Therefore, my lord, go, show me for a friend, till that his rage and anger be forgot.
What if he should bring his armies here while I am gone?
We'll fight to death and mingle our blood together in the earth.
Tyre, I now look from you then. And to Tarsus intend my travel. The care I've had for all subjects good, I lay on you. I take your word for faith, not as your oath. As you a true subject, I'll be a true prince. Tarsus.
He's gone to travel.
How? The king gone?
If further yet, you will be satisfied. He, why he departs, I will give some light to you. In Antioch.
What he says of Antioch?
Royal Antiochus sat sick, took some displeasure at him, and they please our king hearing more. And now, so put himself unto the woman's toil to teach himself at sea of life and death.
Well, I perceive I shall not be hungered now. So, Pericles has gone, escaped the land to fish at the sea. I will pretend to myself.
Peace, Lord of Tyre! My name is Thariad from Antioch.
Lord Thariad from Antiochus is welcome.
From him, I come with message unto Prince Pericles. But since my landing, I have understood your lord and master has departed hence on unknown travel. If this be true, my message must return from whence it came.
Yet, here you shall depart. This we desire, as when to Antioch, we may meet in Tyre.
Away from time.
Shall we let us hear? And my relating tales of others, please. See, still tedious to forget our own.
Oh, my distressed rose. Even such our griefs are like trees. When their branches are trimmed short, they rise even higher than before.
Oh, Dionysa. Who can conceal his hunger till he famish? This Tartus, o'er which I have garment, was filled with riches even in the street. Our towers bore heads so high, they kiss the clouds. Our tables are stored to cut the sight.
Oh, this too true.
But see what heaven can do. But now be gratitude bed for simple bread. Our mothers with their babes are ready now to eat those little darlings whom they love. So sharp our hunger at it that man and wife, Dolores, who first shall die to lend this life. Oh, heaven, hear this tear. May the misery of time come to end.
Where is our Lord Governor Creon?
Here.
Speak out your throat.
We have descried upon our neighboring shore a noble sail of ships make headway.
I thought as much. One throw never comes. Bring her here, some neighboring nation taking advantage of our misery. Now make a conquest of unhappy Tartars.
That's the least fear, for by the semblance of the white flag display, they bring us peace and come to us as favors, not as foes.
No matter what they bring, go, tell them now. We attend him here.
I go, my lord.
Welcome is peace. If peace, it is peace. If war, we are unable to resist.
Creon of Tartus, we have heard your miseries, heard tire. Nor come we to add sorrow to your tears, but to relieve them of their heavy load. And these our ships are stored with corn to make your needy bread, and give whom hunger starved half dead. Life, the god of Greece, protect you. Seek for reverence, but for love and harborage for ourselves, our ships and men. Your grace is welcome to our tongue and us, which welcome we'll accept. Peace here a while, until the star that frowns lends you a smile.
ヘリクリーズを心から崇めています。 しかし間もなくして鶴の手になったら手紙が届き、タルスはもはや安全の地ではないことを伝えてきました。ペリクリーズはこの忠告を聞き入れ、アンタイオカスとサリアードから逃れるため、再び海へと出て行くのです。
Oh, friend, don't you know how to beg? There are some people in our country here to get more money by begging. No, we can get by working.
If you don't know how to beg, do you know how to catch fishing?
I never practiced fishing.
Then you will starve, sure. But there's nothing to be got nowadays unless you can fish for it.
What I have been, I have forgotten, though. But what I am now makes me man so that with cold. I ask your help, which if you so refuse, when I am dead, pray you bury me.
Did you say dead? God forbid! Look! We have a spare coat here. Take it off, man. Come, put it on. Keep warm.
Thank you, madam.
I get my bed. Did you say you cannot beg?
I did not ask for help.
And see, with what success, I won't cut to your back.
What a warm heart these honest fishing people have.
Thank you, sir. Do you know where you are?
Not well.
Then let me tell you, this place is called Pentapolis, and our king is a good old Simonides.
Pentapolis? King Simonides? Do you call him the good Simonides?
Aye, sir. He deserves to be called good for his peaceable reign and good government.
Then he's a happy king. Since he gained from his subjects the name of good by his way of government. How far is it called distant from this shore?
Why, half a day's journey. And I'd tell you, he has a fair daughter. And tomorrow is her birthday. And there are princes and knights come from all parts of the world to fight each other in contest for her love.
If my fortunes were equal to my desires, I too'd like to be one of them.
Oh, sir, things must be as they may.
Help, woman! Help! Here's the fish caught in the net! It can't get out! Drag up on it! It's come as that!
What's that?
And it turned into bits of rusty armor! And a sword!
So, friend, I pray you let me see. Thanks, fortune. This sword was once my own possession, which my dead father did bequeath to me. I have kept it with me always, loved it dearly, till the last deed have given it back again. Thank you, friend. My shipwrecks, harmless now, since now I have the sword my father left me in his will.
Oh, what? What do you mean, sir?
I beg you, kind friend, let me keep this sword and guide me to the court of King Simonides, where I may appear like a worthy gentleman And when my fortune rises once again, I'll pay you for your kindness.
What? Will you compete for the princess Eiza, the daughter of Saigoldi?
I'll show my valiant heart in feats of arms.
Why, take it, and may the gods bless you.
Aye, but listen, my friend. It was we that brought up this weapon through the rough seams of the water. Reward to share. I hope that if you do well at court, you remember and how we found your sword.
Believe me, I will. Only I need a knightly tunic.
Well, provide you. You shall have my best gown, and I take you to the court myself.
If all are wrong, if now the goal of my will, say, I rise in fortune. A fall deeper than the sea.
Inform them we are ready. It's now the honor of your task to receive each knight as each present his shield painted with unique devices.
To preserve my honor, this duty I perform.
And the device he bears upon his shield is a black Ethiopian reaching toward the sun with the words Lux tua vita mihi, which means your light is life to me.
His life depends on you. He loves you, babe.
Macedonia, royal king, and the device he bears upon his shield is a nun knight that's conquered by a lady. The motto in Spanish reads, Piu perdo set perra falta, which means more by gentleness than by force.
A charming sentiment, my dear Caesar.
A wreath of chivalry with these words, Me Pompae Provident Apex, which means the crown of triumph has led me forwards.
Oh, this knight has a strong triumph, O honor.
Present a burning torch that's turned upside down. The motto reads, Qui me alit me extinguit, whoever feeds me extinguishes me.
This shows the great power of beauty. Beauty can influence the heart, and beauty can heal.
By means of a touchstone. The motto reads, Sic spectans fidus, meaning, thus is faithfulness to be tested.
Comes to this trial, strangely attired.
Brilliant, but
lady, the my lady.
Call it by what you will. The day is yours!
Remind me of my father's picture, which shows the glory which he once possessed, with princes sitting like stars above his throne. He that sung for them to liberate, and I, his son, was like a glow-worm in the day, showing its fire in darkness, but nine light. That now, I see that time is the king of men. Time is our grave, and time is our parent. And time gives us what we will, and what we desire.
What? Are you really late? Who can be other than his royal presence?
Here is a cup that is up the brim. It is this health to you!
Yonder night, is it too melancholy? Have you not noticed, Elsa?
What's that to me, father?
Oh, attend my daughter. Princes and kings should freely give to everyone that comes to honor them. Therefore, let's say we drink this bowl of wine to him.
Alas, my father, it does not befit me to be so bold toward a stranger knight. For me to offer him wine may give offense.
What? Do as I tell you, but you will move me to anger.
Now, by the gods, nothing could please me more than now to obey his order. The king, my father, sir, drinks this to you.
My father, come and drink to his health.
Thank you.
example, each trumpet take him to his land. Tomorrow, once again, all do the best! Take my bride.
May we not meet her again, my precious lord?
By no means, sir. For 12 moons more, she'll wear Diana's livery. Until then, vow to keep a virgin honor.
Unwilling to say farewell, we take our leave.
Farewell, good friends.
They are well, they're such!
Now, to my daughter's letter. She tells me here, she's my stranger knight, young Pelquist, a
never again see light of day. Tis well, Caesar. Your choice agrees with mine. I like him well. But how strong, how weary. Choosing a husband, whether I like him or not. Well, I commend her choice. Yes, let her marry Pericles. And here she comes. I must the temple.
All fortune to the good Simonides.
As much to you, sir. Let me ask you one thing. What do you think of my daughter, sir?
A most virtuous princess.
And she is beautiful, is she not?
As beautiful as a summer day. Wondrously beautiful.
And my daughter thinks very well of you.
I am unworthy.
She doesn't think so. In this letter.
Gracious Lord, I am a stranger, a distressed gentleman, and never I am so high to love your daughter. Mary did my best to honor her.
You have bewitched my daughter, and you are villain.
I am no villain. I have never done one thing to gain her love or your displeasure.
Traitor and liar!
Traitor?
Yes, traitor!
Even though you be a king, my gracious lord, call me a traitor and I return that lie!
Now, by the gods, I do applaud his courage.
My actions as noble as my thought, I visit this court in honor's cause. And he that dares to say that I'm a liar, this sword shall prove he's honor's enemy.
Here comes my daughter. She can be a witness.
And Caesar, you are virtuous as fair. Inform your angry father if my tongue had ever spoke a word of love to you.
Why, sir, if you had, who takes offense at what would make me glad?
What, daughter? Is a resolution that so strong? Indeed. I'm glad, but I must tame her willful heart. Do you, not having my consent, bestow your love and your affections upon a stranger? Therefore, hear you, daughter. I shall claim your rich mind, and you, sir, hear you. I shall be ruled by me, or I'll make you. Man, wife. I'm not angry. Calm your hand. And lips must seal it too. And being joined, God give you joy. But are you both agreed?
Yes, if you love me, sir.
Even as the life's blood running in my veins.
But are you both pleased?
Yes, please, your majesty. Yes.
It pleases me so well that I will see you wed, and then with what haste you come, get you to bed.
So take these and say that.
Thank you. Thank you. master. For the coast and not for Tarsail, make for Tarsail.
There will I bid it Creon, for this slave cannot survive the poisonous fire. There I will leave this infant, and you, my coiner, do not disappear me.
Go your way, sailors!
You may have the body, peasantry. Marina, whom for she was born, I have named so. Here I charge your charity with oath, leaving her the infant of your care, beseeching you to give her princely training.
Fear not, my lord. If neglection should make me fail to undertake my duty, the gods revenge it upon me and mine to the end of generation.
I believe you. So, I take my leave. Madam, make me blessed in your care in bringing up my child.
I have a child myself, who shall not be more dear to my respect than you are, my lord.
Madam, my thanks shall pay us. Go, my lord.
Thank you.
What man are those without? Go, listen me. Hate you.
So, leave there.
Sit it here.
What did it?
Sir, even now, did the sea toss up upon our shore this chest?
Let's look up for it.
Whatever it be, wondrous heavy. Whence it open trade?
Now,
beasts. They are creatures.
Thank you.
your oath. You have sworn to do it. It's but one blow, which never shall be known. Let pity melt you, but be a soldier to your purpose.
I will do it. But yet, she is a goodly creature.
The fitter that a god should have her. Here, she comes, weeping for Icorida, the nurse she loves so much. Are you prepared?
I am prepared. I come, Lycorida, once again to strew your green grave with flowers of the earth. The yellows, blues, the purple violets, and marigolds. Shower the carpet dry upon your grave. While the summer days do last, I, me, poor maid, born in the tempest where my mother died, this world to me is one unending storm.
How now, Maria? Why do you walk alone? How chance my daughter Philotheus is not with you? Do not consume your heart with sorrow. Let me become your nurse. Lord, how your beauty fades with all this weeping. Come, give me your flower. Along by the sea, walk now with your line. There, the air is fresh and will restore your look. Come, your line. Walk with Maria.
No, I pray you. Let your servant stay with you. I'm well enough alone.
Come, when Pericles is alive, and find his daughter's beauty blushes thus. He will blame my lord and me, that we have taken so little care of you. Go, I pray you, go and be cheerful once again. Care not for me. I can go home alone.
Well, I will go with Leonina, though I have no will to do so.
Come, I know it's good for you. Walk half an hour, Leonina, at the least. Remember what I have said.
Have no fear, madam.
I leave you, my sweet lady, for a while. Pray, walk softly, do not heat your breath. Indeed, I must take care of you.
My thanks, sweet madam. When I was born, the wind was north.
Was it so?
My father, or my nurse, Lycorida, told me, endured a sea that almost burst the deck.
When was this?
When I was born, never were waves or winds more violent.
Come, say your prayers.
What mean you?
If you require a little time for prayers, I grant it. Pray, but be not slow. For I am sworn to do my work in haste.
Why will you kill me?
To satisfy my mistress, Dionysus.
Why would she have me killed? I never did her harm in all my life. I never spoke bad words, nor ever hurt a living creature. Oh, please believe me. I never killed a mouse, nor hurt a fly. Once I trod upon a worm against my will, but I let go. How have I offended the lady?
My orders are not to give you reason, but to do the deed.
You will not do it for all the world, I hope. Your kindly face tells me you have a gentle heart.
I have sworn, and will defend.
her own bold ship. Quickly.
Well, and has excellent high quality clothes.
How much do we have to pay for her board?
They won't take less than a thousand salary.
Well, follow me, Masters. You shall have your money immediately. Why? Take her in. Instruct her what she has to do. So that she won't be too ignorant or inexperienced when she says, what?
Thank you.
in the night. I say so. Who can question my word? No one knows how Marina died, and no one comes for Leonina's death. Marina was a rival to our child. No one look at Philoten when Marina stood by. This pierced me through my heart. And though you call my act unnatural, it was done for us of our own only child, our Philoten.
May the heavens forgive it.
And as for Pericles, what can he say? We mourned at her funeral. Her tomb is almost finished. All done at our expense.
You are like a devil harpy.
Yes, I know. You do. As I advise.
Thank you.
refuse accepting a place like this.
It's unbelievable. We come to a bawdy house in search of pleasure, and the girl we choose, instead of satisfying our needs, begin to talk about religion, goddesses, Diana, purity.
She has utterly transformed my heart and mind. I will never visit such a place again, except to hear Maria talk. She has said it right now.
She moves me too. It's like a miracle. Till now, we've been living empty, worthless life. But now...
No more body houses for me. Let's go to the temple.
I wish she'd never come here. She will be the ruin of us.
Fie upon her. She freezes up the instruments of all our customers just when they are getting hot. We must get rid of her or somebody must rape her.
Instead of lying down and doing what they're supposed to do with the customers, she gives me excuses and reasons and madness.
She falls down on her knees and says her prayers. Oh, Diana, Diana, please, Diana, 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 Diana.
Yes, you'd better let me ravish her. If she goes on like this screeching and playing, we won't have any customers left.
Yes, get her to bed and rape her.
Yes, and you can give her some of your foxy business. Oh my, here comes Lord Lysimachus, governor of my chin. In disguise as usual.
Good day to you, madam.
I am glad to see your honor in such good health.
Yes, good health. And though I come here for a particular reason, I'd like to keep my health.
Can you find me someone pure and clean?
Yes, sir. We have a new girl here. A perfect rosa. Go and fetch her bowl. Well, she would be a rose if she had burned.
This rose of yours, a rare quality, it seems.
You shall see, sir. You shall see. Here comes the rose that is chained to the stalk. Never picked it, I can assure you. Is she not a beautiful creature?
She has a little something for you. Here, Auntie, please.
I beseech you, sir. Let me have a little word with the girl before I go.
By all means, do.
First, I would like you to understand that this man is the most honorable man.
I will be glad to find him honorable so that I can respect him.
Next. He is the governor of this country, the most powerful lord in my city.
He may govern the country, madam, but that does not mean he is an honorable man.
Now listen, stop all this brazen fencing. Treat him kindly, and he'll supply you with plenty of gold.
If he acts graciously, I will thankfully receive his kindness.
Have you finished talking to him?
My lord, her mind is not well adjusted to the world we live in. You must take some pains to persuade her what she must do. Come, we leave his honor and her together.
Now, pretty one, how long have you been at this trade?
What trade, sir?
I cannot name it. Or I shall offend you.
You cannot offend me, sir. It's the name of my trade.
How long have you been in this profession?
As long as I remember, I have always known it to be good to speak well of this Diana.
I think you misunderstand me. When I speak of your profession, I do not mean the faith you may profess in the gods. I speak
speak of the work
you do in this house.
Which proclaims you to be a creature for sale.
Do you know this house is such a place and yet we are coming into it? I hear that you are an honorable man and you are the governor of my thing.
Did she tell you that? I tell you, pretty one, my powerful position in this country will not place you in any danger. I'll treat you as a friend. Come, sit beside me. Come.
If you truly are an honorable man, show it now. Show that you are worthy of the great position that you hold.
What is this you say? Speak more clearly.
I am still a maid, sir, as pure in body and mind as when I first was thrown into this filthy sty by most and gentle fortune. Oh, that the gods would set me free from this unholy place. Oh, let me change into a simple bird that I might fly into the pure air.
I did not think that such a one in such a place could speak so ill as you do now. No ever dreamed that such a thing were possible. I came here, pure maid, with a corrupted mind. But now, your speech has altered. Look, here's gold for you. Continue the clear way that you are going, and may the gods strengthen you in your purity.
May the good God preserve you.
Though visiting this house for private pleasure, I am not a gentleman of ill intent. And now, your words have made me think this place is vile beyond all sense. Fare you well, you piece of virtue. See here, more gold for you.
I beseech, Jonah, a piece of gold for me.
About you, damn doorkeeper! This house of yours, which has this virgin made here to pump it up, would to sink like a lot of ship and drown you! Away!
What's this? Ah, we must take a different course with you, I can see. Come here, I tell you.
What would you have me do?
I must put an end to your virginity. We can't afford to lose our customers like this. You send them all away and deprive us of our profits. So, now is the time.
How now? What's the matter?
What and what, mistress? She has spoken holy words to the Lord Weissmakers, and he's gone.
This is abominable. And the wretched girl.
She sent Weissmakers away as cold as a snowball.
Bart, take her away. Use her as a prisoner.
Yes, oh, you knew God. She was magic with those gods of hers. Hurry, Bart, away with her. Would she have never come into this house? And you wretched Monterey. Why can't you behave like normal women do, you spicy dish of chastity!
Ha! Come here, mistress. Do what I say.
What will you do to me?
Take away that jewel that is so dear to you.
I pray you. Tell me one thing.
No, what? Let me ask you one thing.
You hold a painful soul in this house that even a fiend in hell would not exchange with you. You, I tell you, are the dumb doorkeeper to every beast that comes in crying for his precious joy. You have to suffer the angry blows of every loud fool lives unsatisfied. The food you eat is such that has been built on by infested lands. This is the life you lead.
What would you have me do?
Do anything but the work you are doing now. And he dressed me at the edge of the sea. Here's some gold for you. I beg you, go into the town, proclaim that I can sing, dance, weave, and sew. And I will undertake to teach all this. I have no doubt that in this popular city, some honorable lord will give me a position.
But can you truly teach these things you speak of?
If you find that I can't, then bring me here and prostitute me to the basest customer that ever comes within these doors.
Well, I will see what I can do for you. If I can find a place, I will.
To work in company with honest women.
I'll do what I can for you.
May the gods reward you.
King, but now you would not think he was a king.
forward and three long months. He has not spoken a single word to anyone. But it is asking that what will keep him alive to continue in his grief.
What grief is this?
His grief are many, but his main grief springs from the loss of his daughter, the beloved wife.
And may I not meet the sorrowful king?
You may, but it will be of no avail. He will not speak to anyone.
Let me see.
He is here. This was a goodly person till the disaster. A single night drove him to this condition.
So, King, all hail. The gods preserve you. Hey, royal sir.
It is in vain, sir. He will not speak to you.
I have never seen a sorrow so profound. Will nothing loathe him?
No voice of man, no cry of bird, no gentle music of the calmest sea. Nothing will move him.
Sir, Rashmaga, let us summon here the gentle lady, Maria. She who charms this town with song and dance.
A timely thought! Yes, to her at once. She questionless, with her sweet harmony, and skill in dance, and gentle conversation, will surely charm the ears of your grieving king.
I entertain no thought that she succeeds.
Yet nothing will omit the may assist our Lord's recovery.
And in the meantime, let me know at large the cause of your most great sorrow.
Sir, I'll tell you all. But see, we are prevented.
Sir, here is a lady you sent for.
Welcome, fair one. Is it not a goodly presence?
She's a gallant lady.
She's such a one. If I wished a wife, I'd wish no better choice. Fair one. See here before us now a kingly patient. If you have art enough to wake his mind and make him answer you, we'll owe you all the wealth that's in the world.
Sir, I use my utmost skill in his recovery. Provided known, but I and my companion may be suffered to come near him.
It shall be so. Come, let us leave her. And the gods make her prosper.
Hello, sir, my lord. no more. Something crawls upon my cheek and whispers in my ears, do not go until he speaks.
Was it not thus what failed?
I said, my lord, if you did know my parentage, you'd think it strange to see my lowly life.
I think I would. Fail, turn your eyes upon me. What is your country? Hear me so.
No, no of any sort.
I am glad with sorrow, and shall unburden my heart with tears. My dearest wife, what like this? My daughter might have been my queen square of silver voice, eyes of jewel-like. Where do you live?
Here, in this town of my dreams, which I can see now from this ship, and where I am a stranger.
Where were you? And how brought up to have such priceless qualities as yours?
If I should tell my history, all my words would sound like lies.
I pity. All of this cannot come to me. You have such modesty. You seem to be a palace for crowned truth to dwell in. I will believe you, for you look like one I love indeed. You said your grief might be as great as mine.
Some such thing I said.
Tell your story, for you have suffered. Gazing on King's grave. Who are your friends? And how did you lose them? And tell me, kind person, what is your name?
My name is Magna.
Oh, I am monarch. And you are sent here by some unkindly, angry god to make the world of what mine is for.
Say that, good sir, or I will say no more.
Say, I'll be patient. You little know how much you care for me by saying your name is Marina.
The name given to me by a king, my father.
What? The king's store. And your name is Marina.
You said you would believe me, but not to be a traveler of your beast. I will end here.
Ah, you flesh and blood. Does your heart beat
How do you move, my dearly boy? Now, where are you at? And why are you called Marina?
Called Marina because I was born at sea.
At sea. Who was your mother?
My mother was the daughter of a king and died the minute I was born. As my good nurse Lycorida has often told me, weeping all the while.
Oh, stop there! This is a restless dream, that ever thou sleep did most sad fool sweet. This cannot be my daughter, who died and is buried. Well, where were you at time?
The king, my father, left me in Tarsus until cruel Creon and his wicked wife did seek to murder me. The villainous one Leonina would have struck me down. But a crew of pirates came and rescued me, rowed me to my train. But, good sir, what do you have me say? Why do you weep? Maybe you think I do not speak the truth. No, in truth I tell you, I am the daughter to King Pericles.
Oh, Pericania, strike me on earth, give me some sense of pain, let this great sea of joy, laughing upon me and overwhelm the shores of my mortality, and drown me with their sweet. Oh, come hither. You who created you, him that created you, you who are born at sea, buried at Tarsus, and found at sea again. Aeneas, down on your knees. Thank the holy God. This is Marina. What was your mother's name? Tell
father,
me.
I
say,
what is your title?
I am Pericles of Tyre. But tell me now, my grand queen's name.
My mother's name was Caesar. Caesar was my mother who did end the minute I began. No.
Blessing on you. You are my child. Give me fresh garments. My own child. And carry that. She is not dead at task and trained by thousands of him. She is your very thing. Who is this?
Sir, it is Governor of Mighty Dashimakas who sings the black flag. From this ship, it comes to see you.
I embrace you. Give me my lord. Oh, heaven, bless my child. Come, my Marina.
Thank you.
of the bidding of my dream. I here confess myself the king of fire, who, journeying from my country, did wed at bright Pentapolis the fair Thaisa. But she in childbed, she died. But there brought forth a maiden child called Marina, who, O goddess, is yet a chaste as you. She at first was told by Creon till at 14 years. His jealous wife made a plan to murder her, but her better part brought her to Mycenae, where trains of purity preserved her. There my ship made port, and there my child made known herself by source.
Your burden must be uncalled.
Maria. Oh, man, she was stable. My royal servant and my friend.
山本。はい、次に私のパートナーであります。アシスタントディレクターの中野を紹介します。グループのダイレクターであります、ヤビン・バンドシです。最後になってしまいましたが、この方がいなければ我々の今日の巡り合いはなかったと思います。ウィリアム・シェイクスピアです。